Good morning, guys. So it's Sunday. It is about 15 till 12. I stayed home from church to be with this little crazy one. And we are going to get some ribs ready to throw on the grill. I am not a rib master on the grill. This is my first time ever doing them on the grill. But I found a very informative website. I think it's called amazingribs.com. This is where I got the idea for all of this. In a previous video, yes, I'm eating an ice cream cone. We get all kinds of crazy here on the weekends, honey. But I made his, it's called Meathead's Memphis Dust. And this isn't exactly right because I am 2 ounces short on paprika, but I think it'll be fine. It's got the majority of everything in there. I just made a mistake and didn't pick up enough paprika at the store. And I forgot it when I went back to the store last night. So it is what it is. I have rinsed my ribs with water and patted them dry. I need to flip it over and remove the membrane because I could tell that they hadn't done that. That's something that he recommends on the site. And then I am going to salt the ribs and sprinkle them with my rub. Okay. So as you can see, there is still a membrane on the back of the ribs. And Meathead, the guy on the website, he says that the membrane not only holds the fat in, but it keeps the flavor out, and that it turns kind of rubbery. So what he says to do is take a butter knife and get it peeled up, kind of start it a little bit. A man's strength would really come in handy. All right, let's see. Yes. Look at that. Okay, we got half of it off. We get another paper towel. All right, guys, that actually peeled off in one solid sheet, just like his did after it started going. So I'm gonna get my ribs salted. This is a big old slab. I'm gonna let this cook for about 4 hours today. I'm getting this all over my stove, but I don't have anything long enough to hold it. Okay. Now I'm going to put on some of my Memphis rub. This is various spices and things like that. He said to cover it to where you can still see the meat, but generously sprinkle. Okay. I'm going to rub everything in at the end, but I want my hands to be clean, touching everything until I rub it. We're going to sprinkle both sides, okay? Now I'm just going to give everything a good rub and all that. All right, so I'll be back and we'll get our grill ready.
All right, guys, so the first step that we're going to do is get our charcoal going. So the first thing you want to do is take your crumpled up newspaper and stuff it up under here, okay? You light your newspaper, is it will start these to cook, and in about 15 to 20 minutes you will have white charcoal. And just so you can see, this is kind of what it looks like while your charcoals are getting cooking. Okay, so when you cook ribs, you want to do it, this is all according to that website, okay? You do it over indirect heat. So you have to look at where your vents are, and you want the smoke and the heat to travel across the ribs. So I'm gonna put my charcoal over here, put my ribs over here. That way the smoke pulls across my meat, okay? This is a learning experience. We're doing this together, guys. But you have to watch your temperature, and you wanna aim for 225 degrees. So I don't have a digital thermometer. My grill has a thermometer, but he said those are unreliable. So I have to, I'm going to use my turkey fryer remote. That's all I know to do. And hopefully that will work. And then I'm also using a couple pieces of barbecuing wood, apple flavor, for to smoke them as well. So this is what we're looking at. I will show you the setup whenever I get it ready. But going to let my charcoal get nice and white before I toss it in. And you actually toss in your charcoal that is burning, and then beside of that you do a pile of charcoal that hasn't been lit, and it works as a fuse. That way there's a constant cooking inside your grill. I'll show you in a minute.
I probably should have gave you a close-up view of that bag of the wood, but this is just apple flavored barbecue wood, and I just got two blocks out. That's what I'm going to use. And this is the digital thermometer that I'm going to use. It says that it will measure oil temperatures up to 410 degrees. So I'm just going to set this inside the grill. This will lay near the meat, the end of the thermometer, and then the actual computer part will set outside of the grill. Okay, and then this is the part that stays inside the house. There we go. So this works actually really well. I've got to plug this in to this little port. So let me see if my charcoal is still smoking, so we still need to give it some time. You'll know it's ready when it's white and there's no more smoke. Okay? All right, guys. So if I look down in there, I can see white coals and orangey fire glow. So I'm going to get my charcoal in there. First thing I'm going to do is put a layer of unlit charcoal, and then I'll layer this. Okay, so let me get my charcoal in the grill.
Oh,
okay, so I'm going to put on my oven mitt, get my hot charcoal. I'm going to put it right here. Okay. Now, I'm going to put my grates back on my grill. Actually, I forgot my step, see? Now I'm going to put a couple of blocks of wood. I dropped that one. Alright, so I have my unlit charcoal, my lit charcoal, and my wood with my pan of water, and then my ribs over indirect heat. I'm going to put my thermometer in close to where the meat is. Okay. Then I'll close this down. Okay. And then I have a remote that also has a place for a timer, so I can monitor everything from inside to see where I'm at. Again, we want this to be as close to 225 as we can. All right, guys, so it is staying right about 227 right now, which is about perfect. And I'm going to take these off probably around 430, 445, somewhere around there. Probably about 445. In order to keep mine at the perfect temperature, I was going to show you what I had to do. I had to get that little chimney and prop open my grill for a bit. I think this is probably just going to be until my charcoal dies down some and the wood that's used to smoke it. But if I close the lid, it's way too hot. So this is what we're having to do right now. All right, guys, so it is 15 till 5, and I just turned off my thermometer. I'm going to take my sauces outside. It is time. Oh, let me grab this skewer. All right, guys, so I brushed half of these with regular barbecue, and I'm brushing the other half with this tangy sauce. And then we're going to put them face down over the charcoal. Guys, so this is what we're kind of looking at. I don't know if they're overdone or not. Oh, yum. So here is your taste test on camera. So good. Oh, God. I think we have a winner.